Hey guys, we are back with another video from the worldofenglishexams.com, a website that provides you with a lot of resources and materials that you would be requiring for any sort of English language exam preparation, like the IELTS or the PT or the CELPIP, OET, whatever it is. So if at all you are in search of materials and all the latest updates, do stay tuned to our channel worldofenglishexams.com. And do check out the other videos on our website www.worldofenglishexams.com. We are always trying to present you with the latest information and in-depth information pertaining to all the different types of questions and all the modules on the IELTS test. So do give this video a big thumbs up and do share it with all of your friends. And don't forget to subscribe. So yes, with that information, let's get started with today's video, which is on the IELTS reading module. And today we are going to deal with diagram labeling. This is one of the very frequently asked questions, and it is compulsory for you as the test taker to understand what exactly is diagram labeling. So without any further delay, let's get into the topic. Oh yes, so as you can see on the screen, there are various question types that you may see on the reading test, such as the note completion, diagram labeling, which we are going to cover in this video. Then there's table completion, summary completion, flowchart completion, true or false or not given, yes or no or not given. Then there is multiple choice question type, then short answer questions, matching questions. All of this along with the detailed explanation and the material can be found on www.worldofenglishexams.com. So don't forget to check them out. Okay, so let's get started with today's video by understanding some of the useful tips that you would be requiring to get the diagram labeling questions correct. Okay, so as you can see, there are many useful tips which are listed on the screen. So the first one is, you must read the title very carefully. Yes, you have heard me right. Titles will be given for the diagrams which you need to read very carefully, because often the title gives us some of the keywords that can help us to locate the passage in which the description for the diagram lays. Then there is a second tip, which is you need to mark the right keywords. Guys, if you have already checked our other videos, such as the IELTS flowchart completion and IELTS note completion types and IELTS summary completion videos pertaining to the reading module, you might have already known. If you did not check them out, do click the I button here or there or somewhere else, and you can definitely find that link to the video. So do check them out, guys, because I have given about all the keywords and how to identify the keywords in detail. So don't forget to check that out. As for this video is concerned, let me just highlight what exactly are the keywords that you need to be marking. Firstly, nouns, that is naming words. Then we have verbs, which can be given in their synonymous form. Then we have adjectives, which describe the nature of nouns. Then we have adverbs, then prepositions and articles, which are a, an and the, which ultimately indicate that the answer is a noun. So if at all you check the other videos pertaining to the IELTS reading module, you can get to know the information about how to accurately identify the keywords. Then the next useful tip is, try to predict the answer and then read the text. Guys, this is a common mistake which most of the candidates commit. That is, they try to read the text in detail and then come to the questions. That is a wrong approach, guys, because there is a strict time limitation on the IELTS reading test. So we don't have any additional time to give the passage a second read. So when you're reading for the first time itself, do read the questions initially and then proceed to reading the paragraph. And please don't follow the opposite. It definitely takes a lot of time, guys. Then the next useful tip is, guys, this is very, very, very important. For this type of questions, the answers may not be in an order in the passage. So generally, for the other type of fill-in-the-blanks question, the answers will be in an order. They'll follow a sequence, but not for this question type. For diagram labeling, the answers may be in an order or they may not be in an order. So it is very essential for us to note this point. Okay, then we need to perform the skimming and scanning techniques as we have discussed in the other videos. Please do check them out so that you get to know what exactly is skimming and scanning. So we need to scan the passage very carefully to get the right answer, and then you need to read it in detail. Okay, then an important tip, especially keeping the word count in mind, is that hyphenated words, that is the words which are separated by hyphen, as you can see the example, cooperation. Okay, this is considered to be one word. Okay, and as always, the spellings are really important. Also, you must note whether the answer should be a singular or a plural. Then, firstly, you also need to check the word limit, whether the answer should be in a single word or it can be in two words or three words or whatever it is. You need to note the word limit, guys, because if you exceed the word limit, even though your answer is right, you will be marked wrong, and there is always a risk of lowering your score by not paying attention to these key details. So just pause the video here if you feel that you want to give the tips another read. Else, after getting to know the useful tips, why don't we take up a diagram and try to solve it? Shall we do it? Fine. Oh yes, so this is how a diagram looks, guys. Have you seen that there are a few instructions given with a title followed by a diagrammatic representation? Okay, so I'll help you out to how to do this step by step. So do stay tuned. Now, as you can see, what is the instruction given to us? Choose one word from the passage. So what is the word limit here? It is strictly one word. So you need to restrict the answer to a single word only. If you write the second word, then it will be wrong. Then another important tip is to read the title very carefully. So what is this title? How a boat is lifted on the Falkirk wheel. Okay, so this is the title, and we need to understand that this is a process of lifting a boat. So, and here, what are the keywords? Obviously, boat, then will be lifted, and the name of the wheel. So these are the key details that we need to know. Then look at the number of questions here, guys. Yes, so they start from 20. So reading the question very carefully is the first step in getting the answers right. So let's start from reading the 20th question. A pair of dash are lifted in order to shut out water from the canal basin. So a pair of something, and here a pair of something indicates that the answer is a noun, because here clearly they are telling that it is a pair. So only nouns can exist in pairs. So the answer is definitely going to be a noun, and something, a pair of something are lifted in order to shut out water from the canal basin. Then let's see what's going to happen next. A dash is taken out, enabling the wheel to rotate. So as we can understand, something is stopping the wheel from rotating, and if that is taken out, the wheel can rotate freely. Again, after a, which is an article, there is a blank. So the answer is definitely a noun. That too, the answer is a singular noun. Then next one, hydraulic motors drive dash. Here hydraulic motors is our keyword, and these hydraulic motors are driving something. Okay, and that definitely is going to be a noun, because after a verb, if there is a blank, then the answer can be predicted as to being a noun. Next one, let's see the 23rd question. A range of different sized dash ensures boat keeps upright. So the boat is kept upright because of different size, that means they are of various sizes, and definitely sizes will be for nouns only. So that is the reason even the 23rd answer is a noun. Next one, boat reaches top wheel then moves directly on to. So the boat is first reaching the top wheel and it is then moving directly on to something. Guys, here we need to note the preposition on to. So the boat is moving directly on to. We need to get the same meaning in the passage, and only then we must confirm that that is the right answer. Next one, boat travels through tunnel beneath Roman dash. Roman something. So something which is built by the Romans, or something which belongs to the Romans. We need to find a noun. Next one, 26. Dash raise boat 11 meters to level of Union Canal. So something is raising the boat 11 meters. Here, if at all there are any numbers, we need to mark them as the keywords, because numbers will not be changed. So you can find them, you can locate them very easily. So something is raising the boat 11 meters to level of Union Canal. So here we need to search for all these blanks, and now let's proceed on to locating our first keyword, which is for the 20th question. A pair of dash are lifted. We need to find the same context as this. Now let's go and search. Yes, as you can see, the paragraph starts with the word lifted. Let's read that sentence. Boats needing to be lifted up enter the canal basin at the level of the Forth and Clyde Canal and then enter the lower gondola of the wheel. Two hydraulic steel gates are raised. Guys, did you locate that? So two hydraulic steel gates are raised so as to seal the gondola off from the water in the canal basin. So here, when we go back to the question, we can see a pair of. So here, a pair is given as two. So what are raised, guys? Steel gates are raised. However, here we can see that the word limit is one word. So we need to omit the word steel and we need to give the answer as gates. So a pair of gates are lifted in order to shut out water from the canal basin. Have you got it? You need to write the answer in the plural form. Please mind that. Next one, a dash is taken out enabling wheel to rotate. Now let's see the context. Okay, let's read it from the canal basin from where we have stopped. The water between the gates is then pumped out. A hydraulic clamp which prevents the arms of the wheel moving. So which is preventing the wheel from moving? A hydraulic clamp is preventing. Now, have we got the right answer, guys? Yes. So, which must be taken out in order for the wheel to rotate? Hydraulic clamp. So, however, the word limit is one word. Hence, we need to write the answer as clamp. Clamp is the answer. Okay, fine. So, then we can see that the 22nd answer is hydraulic motors drive dash. So we need to search for the next keyword, which is hydraulic motors. Let's go back to the passage. Okay, so we have got the answer as hydraulic clamp. Okay, and if you look at the next sentence, in the central machine room an array of 10 hydraulic motors then begin to rotate the central axle. So what are the hydraulic motors helping to rotate or helping to begin? They are helping to rotate the central axle. So they are driving the central axle. So here drive and rotate are synonyms. Here we need to write the answer as axle. We don't need to write the word central because we have the word limit of one word only. Have you understood it? Now let's proceed to the next question. A range of different sized dash ensures boat keeps upright. So we need to search for the text which says a range of different sized, various sized or whatever it is. Let's see. Okay, the axle connects to the outer arms of the wheel, which begin to rotate at the speed of 1/8 of a revolution per minute. As the wheel rotates, the gondolas are kept in upright position by a simple gearing system. 2 8-meter wide cogs. Guys, as you can see, they are now talking about sizes. So 2 8-meter wide cogs orbit a fixed inner cog of the same width, connected by 2 smaller cogs. So 2 cogs are of 8 meter and 2 other cogs are smaller than that. So this is the context which says that they are differently sized. But what exactly are differently sized? Yes, you have guessed it right. So the answer is cogs. You need to write the answer as cogs, because here they have given a range of, that means variety of. So the answer will be cogs for the 23rd question. Next, let's move on to the 24th one. Here, as we mark the keywords, boat reaches top wheel, then moves directly on to. So we need to find the preposition of where the boat exactly is moving after it reaches the top wheel. Okay, then let's continue from here. When the gondola reaches the top, guys, we have found the keyword top, the boat passes straight onto the aqueduct. So where is the boat passing? The boat is passing onto aqueduct. That is the answer for the 24th one. Now let's see the 25th. Boat travels through tunnel beneath Roman dash. So the keyword will be Roman and tunnel. Let's read it from here. The remaining 11 meters. Guys, have you noticed? We found another keyword, but not for this question, but for the next question. Here we have noticed 11 meters. Okay, let's read it. The remaining 11 meters of lift needed to reach the Union Canal is achieved by means of a pair of locks. So what are helping to achieve the 11 meters of lift? A pair of locks. So that is the answer for 26th question. Guys, here have you noticed that the answers are not always in an order? That is exactly what I mean to convey in the useful tips that we have learned. So the answer for the 26th one is locks. Locks, L-O-C-K-S. Okay, next one. Now let's see where we get the word Roman. The wheel could not be constructed to elevate boats over the full 35 meter difference between the two canals owing to the presence of a historically important Antonine Wall, which was built by the Romans in the 2nd century AD. So what did the Romans build? The Romans built an Antonine Wall. So what is the answer for the 25th question, guys? So the answer will be wall, because the word limit is 1. So have you got the answers? Have you got to understand how to do a diagram labeling? Okay, so now let's see the answers. Yes, as you can see, the answers are right. And this is taken from Cambridge 11 of the academic series. Now, why don't you practice one more diagram labeling? Why don't you label a diagram and check for yourself whether you have understood the concept or not? Are you ready? Fine. So here goes the question for you. Okay, so as you can see, it is talking about an undersea turbine, and here please check out the word limit. It is no more than 2 words, which means you can write the second word and you should not be writing the third word. You can write 1 word or a maximum of 2 words. So as we have understood how to do it, just look at the questions initially. There are a total of 4 questions here, and ideally you need to be solving them within 5 minutes. So I'll alert you at the end of the 5th minute, and your time, here is the passage, and your time starts Now, please write the answers in the comment section. Since the answers are not in an order, please search for the ones which you can find very easily, and then you can come back for the ones which you could not solve earlier. So yes guys, do pause the video if you require time to solve that, and here are the answers for that. So after you complete that, do check the answers. So have you understood how to label a diagram? So this is very important guys. And last but not the least, do give this video a huge thumbs up if you like it, and comment and let us know how you feel about the video and what other videos you are expecting from us, and do share it and don't forget to subscribe. So till I see you the next time, take care, all the very best with your IELTS exam preparation. Bye.